So, the Tower Defense X Halloween event trailer just dropped, and I just wanted to get a quick video analysis out there because this trailer has a ton of secrets in it that need to be dissected. No wasting time on an intro or anything, so, you know, just be sure to like, subscribe, and let's jump into it. So, we start off the trailer with a bunch of dead towers in some sort of city. I can't exactly make out who's dead in the front, but we see Toxinator and what appears to be Sniper and some other towers just scattered around. We then cut to the purple spider guy, who we can easily assume is the main antagonist of this event. He speaks to his armies before introducing us to his minions. Here, take a listen.
Arise, O Horde! Arise, O Possessed! Arise, O Possessed! Arise, O Corrupted!
I assume he is introducing us to the three main chapter threats of this event. Actually, I believe there will be four chapters, but we'll get to that later. These enemies are of the first three, in my opinion. We have the Horde, or the Army of the Dead, first. I assume that this is the first group, which will be the first night of the event, because for all intents and purposes, they are the least threatening enemies shown in this trailer. The second group we are shown are the Possessed, which I assume will be composed largely of corrupted versions of our towers, but on a much larger scale than what we've seen in the normal game modes. We've already seen possessed golden juggernauts, but I imagine there will be even more. These, I believe, will be the threats of Night 2. Next, we get the Corrupted, which I think we'll be facing on Night 3. These guys are probably going to be mostly Xenon's forces from Expert and Endless, but taken over and, well, corrupted. We see the Apex Predator with his core torn out and some sort of flesh visible. We also see the same for Eradicator Mark 2, and some sort of Calamity Grenadier in the center. This confirms to me that this event is purely the Calamity's doing, and that Xenon is being just as negatively impacted as we are, which might be hinting towards some sort of team-up since, you know, these guys have stolen her toys and such. Next, we get shots of the purple guy giving his speech again, while the towers are being attacked by Weeping Angels, zombies, and undead eradicators. In this shot here, we see what appears to be a sniper as well as a laser gunner, or maybe refractor, being attacked. We see corrupted tanks and Calamity mechs marching into war. Also, side note, we know that these are Calamity property, because in previous leaks we have seen these vehicles marked with the symbol of the Calamity, showing that even though these demons are from Hell, they still possess technology. Although it's unknown where they got it from, but you know, their leader is a literal spider robot thing, so I'm not really going to question it. Finally, at the end of the trailer, we can see the purple guy reveal himself to be a techno-organic humanoid, in a similar vein to the Eradicators, but a lot more messed up. This guy is completely insane, even having the Calamity symbol tattooed to his forehead. Without a doubt, he is going to be the night's final villain. At the end, we get the splash artwork, and it mostly shows things that we are familiar with one extra addition. We got another look at a giant corrupted Wendigo. If you didn't know, Wendigos are pretty famous, reoccurring enemies that have appeared in tower battles as well as TDX itself. Although the Snow Wendigo in TDX isn't as relevant to what's happening here. This Wendigo seems to be chained up and corrupted by the Calamity, which is interesting. This event appears to be pulling from all aspects of the TDX lore. The Purple Spider Guy has the Undead, the Corrupted GDA, the Undead Xenon Machines, and even Legacy Tower Battles enemies under his control, which really makes him, and this event, a culmination of everything we've faced in the game up to this point. Jumping into theory territory, I think it is entirely possible that this purple guy, or the order that he is a part of, are the ones behind the Void Heart structures within the Scorched Passage and Tower Battles maps. The Limbo map could very well be their home, and this guy could have easily been the one to summon the Void to begin with, as well as the one who summoned the Void Heart during the TB event. Besides the obvious sharing of the purple color palette, both seem to have the ability to possess and control the GDA's units, which I think is a very interesting and intentional detail. Also, since John has mentioned in the past that the Void is meant to be a dark god, and we managed to kill him, perhaps this purple guy is merely a cultist following in his place. It would explain his anger towards us quite a lot more. We quite literally killed his god, and now he's out to destroy us for what we've done. But anyways, that's really all I've got for this video. You know, it was just a quick analysis. So remember to like and subscribe if you want to see more regarding the TDX event and other things like that. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye.
You should, if you, you should edit that Quicksilver music on.